27 to authorize the CAO to execute a grant contract between the city and the Richmond 2015 for the purpose of making a gift of $500,000 to Richmond 2015 Inc. to defray a portion of the cost of preparation for the 2015 Union Cyclists International Road World Championships to be held September the 19th through September the 27th in the city.
Okay, how many questions do we have? Do we need a presentation on this?
No, we don't need one. I just want a question.
All right.
Why $500,000? That's a heck of a lot of money.
I think that, that warrants us having appreciation for the budget as relates to this, earnings event of town. Is anyone here to speak in regards to the budget? So we can understand why it's $500,000, thank you.
Madam President, I am Suzette Ensel of the mayor's office. I am not here to speak on paper. We've just gone to get Mr. Marshall, who would be knowledgeable.
So I think that it's important, Ms. Franklin, that you have some meetings with us specifically. So we'll come back to this paper, next paper, Mr. Clerk.
The next item, both 11 and 12, I believe, are related to 1501 Commerce Road location. Item number 11, ordinance number 2012-228, to transfer per funds in the amount of $800,000 from the Department of Public Works and $1.9 million from debt in fiscal year 2012-2013 to amend fiscal year 2012-13 debt service fund budget by reducing budget expenditures in the amount of $1.9 million within the long-term debt and to amend fiscal year 2012-13 capital budget by appropriating such transfer funds in the amount of $2.7 million to the Boulevard Redevelopment Preparation Project in the Economic and Community Development category for the purpose of acquiring real property at 1501 Commerce Road for the relocation of facility management services of Richmond Public Schools from locations owned by the city along the Boulevard. And item number 12, ordinance number 2012-229, to declare a public necessity for and to authorize the acquisition of 7.98% portion of real property known as 1501 Commerce Road for the purpose of housing facility management services for Richmond Public Schools.
Questions? Ms. Franklin?
Does this mean where the buses are at, is it Delta Terminal? They're going to be moved now to Commerce?
No.
So they can stay over there then?
Any other questions? Mr. Yule? No? Any other questions?
Madam Vice President.
Mr. Towel?
I, you know, this is a related paper to the whole conversation of moving the service departments from the Boulevard where the diamond is. And we're doing this for economic development. The last several months, I've asked, you know, what is the game plan? Is the game plan in place? I've yet seen anything that shows why we're spending this money now as opposed to holding off and getting this game plan in place. I feel like we're putting $5 to $7 million worth of improvements into projects that basically the existing buildings are functioning for us and ultimately we're going to see these buildings fade or raised. And quite frankly, I feel like this point, you know, we need to have the game plan for the Boulevard presented to city council for meeting dates, meaningful dates. So, you know, I don't know what real estate wants to say about it, but at this point, it's unfortunate we're spending a lot of money and then we're going to hold on property.
Good afternoon, my name is Jane Ferron, Economic and Community Development. And I did have a presentation that I'm happy to give on this project that might help me articulate some of the questions that you have.
I
understood that the contract was sent and loaded. If not, I can walk you through the hard copy. So why don't I, since you have a hard copy, why?
Yeah.
Okay, I think you may recall that a couple months ago, I was here talking about relocation and repositioning strategy. And that strategy was undergirded by some goals and objectives that I articulated the last time.
Oh, good.
We last spoke about this when we had some other papers related to some real estate transactions for some leases on the boulevard. As far as our plan, the goal is to reposition the boulevard property for development to its highest and best use, and more importantly, to get that very valuable property on the tax roll based on its highest and best use. By doing this and relocating the city functions, which are clearly an underutilization of this property, the goal is to catalyze and revitalize the boulevard corridor, increase tax base, stimulate economic development, new investment, and also as a parallel track to this strategy, our goal is to, when we can, leverage city assets and city functions and activity and investment in areas of the city that really need a shot in the arm, where the public sector has not been willing or quite as willing to invest. So this is the Boulevard property, the 60 acres, and Mr. Tyler, to answer your question, the area circled in yellow is about 19 acres, and that constitutes phase one of the Boulevard relocation project. The paper that we're talking about today finishes phase one, okay? We've already considered a paper to relocate fleet services onto Commerce Road. We've identified that property, and we are finalizing a contract to purchase that property. The other functions in the White House are for Richmond Public Schools. If you recall, there was a purchasing and warehousing function that we are relocating to Hermitage Road under a lease. And then the third function, excuse me, in that particular building is the facilities maintenance function for RPS. And if you also recall, originally, we were negotiating for a property along the Brook Road corridor. Unfortunately, somebody else put that property under contract, so we went back to the market to identify an appropriate building to house this specialized function for Richmond Public Schools. And this is just a closer-in shot. So, Mr. Tyler, we have already identified and have negotiated contracts for all the other uses within that 19 acres, with the exception of this remaining use, which is the which is facilities management. Once we relocate all of these functions off of the 19 acres, we'll begin the process of remediating and demolishing the existing structures, which goes towards getting the property ready for redevelopment in the future. So the property that we've identified is located at 1501 Commerce Road. Some of you may recall that this property, it's about 60 acres, and for many, many years it housed tobacco for Philip Morris. A developer acquired that property probably about 5 or 6 years ago. The property is currently substantially vacant. That developer came in and took some risk and made some investment along Commerce Road and has been actively marketing this property for quite some time. He has landed several tenants in the property, but clearly has a significant amount of property still available. That developer has offered to deliver to us 7.9 acres along the back section along Bruce Street. And there is an existing warehouse facility that the developer will renovate specifically for our needs and sell to us for $2.7 million. Now, this particular use is a fairly specialized use because of facilities management and the work that they do. We needed small bay workshops. We needed fully conditioned space. There was not an existing building in the marketplace that could meet our immediate needs. This building needs it fairly well. Richland Public Schools has endorsed this location and has worked very closely with with us and the developer and space planner to formulate a space plan that works for them here. The building will be, as I said, 50,000 square feet and will encompass workshop spaces, our Richland Public Schools fleet vehicle and large vehicle storage. 100 Richland Public Schools employees will be located in this location. And this developer will sell it to us in turnkey conditions. So basically, we can move in and immediately operate in this facility. And most importantly, we are creating some activity along Commerce Road, which is this area is very much in need of investment and activity. Now, the Crenshaw property is just due north. I think you can see it at the very top, maybe the corner of the Crenshaw property, sort of catty corner, northeast corner of the overall site. And then the property that you just considered at 1801 is just due south on the same stripe, same side of Commerce Road. So getting back to your question, Mr. Tyler, with regard to the plan is going to be a process, okay? And of course, the process will include developing a master plan of some sort for that Boulevard commercial corridor. In fact, it is one of our priorities in economic development. But before we can execute any plan, we've got to relocate these existing functions off the boulevard. Mr. Bachelor mentioned earlier that there is a phase two. So once we are able to complete these transactions that you have recently heard and approved, we will move forward with space planning and the relocation of those phase two uses. And we have to do this before the property can be cleaned and the existing structures demolished.
Ms. Farrar, let me try it this way. I appreciate what you're saying, and obviously, like you, I have a lot of expertise in this area. And I guess the question that I've been trying to ask and have not been need to do so is, we're trying to reposition the Boulevard property. When do you actually think the earliest is that this property would be sold and bought back with a tax write-off?
The Boulevard property?
Yes.
I can't give you an exact date.
I mean, is it 3 years? Is it 5 years? Is it 2 weeks? You know what I'm saying? Okay. I mean, this has been my problem with this process is I feel like in some ways we've got the cart in front of the horse because we said that in order for us to do this, we had to move all these folks off. But at the same time, I'm very familiar with large-scale development and how long it takes to get something in place. And dollars being what they are, I keep asking the question, when do we think we're going to actually bring this property back on the tax rolls? Because that's the goal, which I believe ultimately.
And we would be delighted to keep you apprised of our activities, but I cannot give you a date today.
Well, again, I just wish, it's just, I feel like I'm buying a paper to hold this. All right, thank you.
Yes, Ms. Farrar, comments about phase two, we just learned what phase one is. You're telling us you have a phase two, but we don't know what it is. I think that's partly his question, perhaps even with an answer to what phase two generally looks like. We could almost extrapolate a time in which that can be made ready for development and acquisition and sale. So you got us operating in a vacuum here. It seems like you know the answer that we're just asking, can we know?
Well, let me explain to you what phase two is, just so you understand.
Mm-hmm.
That section that borders Hermitage Road and those properties that front the road north is right there, right in here. About 12 acres. Many of those buildings are currently vacant. There are several structures that are either not being utilized or are underutilized. So that's phase two. As Mr. Beschler mentioned earlier, we have hired a space planner to determine whether or not those functions that are currently in phase two could fit within the property on Commerce, the Crenshaw property on Commerce. That constitutes phase two. So what that does is that will clear out all of this property right here for redevelopment.
All of which is owned by the city?
All of which is owned by the city.
Okay.
That's correct.
There's still a matter of the sports package racetrack and stadium. There's still a matter of the off-ash going. We got no idea what's going to happen with all of that. How much space are we trying to make? What phase is that supposed to be? So that perhaps we could even extrapolate how soon it could be made ready. I don't know whether environmental tests have to be done. Don't know, Scott. You want to help us out this morning?
Yes, sir. First, with respect to the time, I think Mr. Vestal came and told you that we were already doing space planning to move people from this Hermitage Road side of the project out to Crenshaw property. So we'll have a sense of that in about 45 days. And I think we shared with you, the council earlier, our plan for development of Boulevard site. The current plan says that the detailed analysis of the market, detailed market analysis will be done by the end of February. We would issue a developer RFP by March, this is 13. Get a developer on board late summer, early fall of 13. And the first phase of construction starts sometime in 14. Assuming the development plan works, we get financing in place, those things. But the goal is to have a developer on board this time, I'm sorry, 6 months from now, basically.
All right. Madam President, may I?
Thank you.
I do remember that timeline laid out. What I'm missing is, as we vacate that property and make it available to people to develop, and as it's cleared off and removed of any environmental issues that we are involved with, what is the enhanced value of property or potential enhanced value of property compared to what we're spending in terms of clearing it off? And does the margin favor us, or are we swapping and breaking even, or what?
$1 million to move the people off of this site. but it opens up almost 60 acres for development.
And you have no idea what the estimated value of that property ready for development, what the value of that property would be versus what we're spending here.
Detailed market analysis will be completed in February. That will tell us what potential is and what we should ask the developers to proposal, what kinds of things that they would choose to develop in this area. We'll also piggyback off of the work that's done by Councilmember Sanders from the neighborhood, where they said the kinds of things they would like to see. Our goal is not just to look at that 60 acres, but to look on all sides of it to see what the other development potential is. Their warehouses are not fully utilized. Their uses in that area that probably could work better someplace else.
And you know, there's the Arthur Ashe property that was virtually killed by virtue of demolition by neglect. There's Park Field across the road there that is being used as a ball field. I don't know whether there's any contemplation of including that. I haven't heard anything to that in that regard.
I'll try to speak to those two things.
All right.
With respect to the Arthur Ashe Center, schools and this school wrote a several months ago offering to provide the Arthur Ashe Center to us because they didn't want to place a roof for major schools with a cost of $1 million. They also said that they had other places to conduct most of the events that they currently carry out in the Arthur Ashe Center. A week or so ago, maybe 2 weeks ago, they surplused some buildings to us. They did not include the Arthur Ashe. They decided to wait until after the new school board comes in before doing that. So we'll have that conversation again when the new school board takes their seats. With respect to the Parker Field across Robinson Road, that is being considered as part of the development. It may end up not being, but at least right now we're considering this part of the 60 plus acres of development. Sports Backers, you asked about as I was coming in. We have had only cursory conversations with them, and we probably won't have any real in-depth conversations until we get the detailed market analysis and before we send out an RFP. So we don't presume that we will be using their money. And as we do the study on the best use of the stadium, city stadiums, we would like to have conversations with them about perhaps relocating to a new spot like the stadium.
Makes sense.
Sure.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Any other questions? Okay. Yes?
Okay, Madam President, item number 13, ordinance number 2012-230. So then,